Chuck, what the hell's wrong with you?
I didn't take your check, I asked for it. I thought something had happened to you. So who is she, Jamal?
Who's who?
Oh, okay. You went out to see what it came to me. Okay, hold up.
What are you doing? Who are you calling?
Hold on.
Hello?
Yes, may I please speak with Jamal, please?
Jamal is at home right now, sweetie. Can I take a message?
Yes, can you please tell him that his girlfriend, Tyler, called?
Oh, okay. Well, wait, girlfriend? Jamal has two girlfriends?
Excuse me? What do you mean?
Jamal goes out with my daughter. Jamal stays here with me and my daughter. Now look, Jamal doesn't need this type of drama in his life right now. He has a one-year-old daughter he needs to attend to.
No, I'm not, but thank you for the information anyway.
Well, all right, baby, bye-bye.
One-year-old baby, Jamal? How could you?
Sorry, I'm sorry.
What, sorry? Don't give me that bull, Jamal. That's what every man says when he gets caught. And I...
You all right?
Oh, get the hell away from me. Why, huh? Why can't you just be real with me, Jamal? What happened to, you know, I just want you to be my wife. What happened to that? Well, you know what, that's right. Maybe your baby mama already had that spot already.
Tyler, I know I messed up, but you just ruined. When we met, I did fall in love with you. Me and her, we were going through some things and we were separated. That's when my boy and I made his career in his car. And I saw how fascinated you were with me, the career, and the car. That I just kept the act up. But the love part, it wasn't an act. I do love you. So sorry that we wasted our time.
You know, you must have been a real kiss-ass all your life, and everything you're saying to me right now is full of it. You know what? Get out, Jamal. Get it out, Jamal. Get the hell out of my house. I don't ever want to hear anything from you or see you ever again. Get out!
I just didn't appreciate that you didn't mention your mom and dad. But she can't help that she's all messed up. But back to my wonderful guy.
You know.
own crib. Jamal ain't got his own crib. He living with his baby mama. Tyler, don't you see the difference?
Now why don't you like Alonzo? Because Alonzo is just too much for me. I mean, yeah, he's nice and he has his own crib and his own car.
Exactly.
But he's just too much of a gentleman for me. I mean, I'm like a rough type of guy. And Alonzo is just too soft.
Wait. You act like that towards him because you think he's too soft.
Yeah, I mean, every time I meet him, he never does anything or says anything. He just leaves. And I don't need a man like that.
So you'd rather a man knock you on your ass and put you in the hospital? Look here, baby girl. You better watch what you ask for, because you just might get it. Alonzo is a nice man. Why don't you like him?
Look, Becky, I already told you, okay? I'm gonna talk about him anymore.
I can't believe this. He's such a nice guy, and you just put him over to the side that he wasn't nice and knocked him on your ass and put you in the hospital? Is that logical to you?
I don't know. I just love Jamal, and I still miss him.
Wait a minute. You still miss him and you still love him? That ain't no love. What would love got to do with it, huh? And if you think that is love, then you don't really know what love is. Listen, come on. Alonzo, he loves you. He really wants to be with you. You better wake up and not let his love pass you by. Because if you do, you may never get that again. I just can't believe that you slept with him on the first night.
Why? I didn't see anything wrong with it.
That's what they all said.
Who?
The hoes.
Becky, call me